during conference play or more double and triple teams?
So. Yeah. Just like what you said with the double and triple teaming, I just have to pass out of the post, I feel like, a little bit quicker. I need to make more quicker moves, I feel like, just to get open and just to get open and score. I feel like that's what I have to do.
When you first started seeing that, was there frustration with it? Was it the challenges? How was that mental approach for you?
Yeah, definitely. Just never seeing it before and just having to adjust to it. I felt like the first like two or three games I was struggling a little bit, but just adjusting to it, really.
Vernon, how have you seen Garrison Brooks' game improve, and what sort of a challenge does he provide for you?
He's a good player, a great player. Just like watching film over the past like two seasons, just seeing him progress. And, I mean, it's going to be a battle tomorrow, so this is what I'm looking forward to.
Coach mentioned you running the floor more, wanting to kind of get you out running more. How do you go about doing that? And just in terms of obviously not physically the running part, but mentally preparing yourself when a shot goes up or whatever, getting in that transition.
Just to probably get down. He wants me to get down the court quicker, so I won't see those double teams or stuff like that. So just me being able to just score quickly and not see those double or triple teams.
Have you changed how you might go about like getting the defensive rebound in order to get out running faster? Like, has any of that process kind of changed?
I mean, no, just whenever if I don't get the rebound, the defensive end, I'll just sprint. But it's the same process that I had.
Is that, obviously I'm not a big man, but you know what, is that just something that big guys aren't necessarily used to doing, because you figure the guards are going to advance it and everything is going to be set up for you by the time you get down court? I guess I'm asking, why is that just not natural for most big men to automatically get out?
I mean, probably because most big men don't get double or triple team. I feel like so. Just probably that. Just getting down the court quicker and just trying not to see those double or triple teams.
How was your adjustment bit to playing with Trey, where in that situation he gets the ball out quicker down court than just about anybody in college basketball right now?
Yeah, just like what you said, Coach wants us to run, because Trey, he'll find you if you run the floor. So just running the floor, I feel like just opens up those scoring opportunities for everyone.
Trey mentioned how for him last year around February is when he started to hit a little bit of a wall. Did you ever feel like you hit any of that? And what has he sort of told you to keep pushing through it, I guess, if that it did exist?
Yeah, probably like when I first started seeing those double teams come, like in probably like December or November, like early December. So he just told me to keep on, just prepare for it. And just, at first I wasn't prepared for it, so that's probably why I struggled a little bit. So just, I've been working on it, so just the preparation, I feel like I've been doing okay with it.
How did last month's UNC game compare to your personal victories?
That UNC game was crazy. Just with us coming back, us being down by like 10 or 12, with like, I don't even know how much minutes left, but just that atmosphere, that level of intensity, it'll probably match or even be greater tomorrow, I feel like. So just that, and that win was big for us, because I think we had a game 2 days after FSU, I'm not sure. So just those were two key wins for us, so I feel like it just led us in the right direction.
You've been able to draw a lot of fouls this year. I think average per game is about as high as anybody in the country.